Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel, and oh my god, we hit 2k. Holy sh**, guys. I told you I needed more time like the other day and you guys were like, nah bro, we got you, 2k. So f**ing thank you. Oh my god, like seriously, I didn't think that I would hit 2k this fast. I mean, what was the last milestone? A few months ago? Last year sometime? I don't remember when the last milestone was. I've got brain damage, but like, I'm genuinely so proud of myself for getting to this point, and I am so incredibly thankful for all of you who have been there for me, who have subscribed, who have come to all the live streams, who have commissioned me, who have supported me just in general these past like few years, especially more recently. And I just want to say that I love all of you to death. Like, you're all so awesome, and I love hanging out with you guys and the people who I have talked to in this community. You guys are so fun. I love seeing your comments. Every time I see a familiar name in the comments, I get really excited. I'm like, oh, I know that person. I remember them from a live stream. Ah, and I get super excited that you are still around and still enjoying my content, because I mean, that's kind of why I'm making it at this point. A while back, I said that I was making content for myself, and that's still true for sure, but I'm also now making content for a huge community, and even though it might not be the biggest community, it's still a huge community, at least for me. And seeing those familiar faces around genuinely makes me so happy, because this is something that I never thought that I would be able to achieve. So, from the bottom of my heart, genuinely, thank you. This means the absolute world to me. You have no idea. I hope that we can continue growing our community and that we'll hit 3K, you know? Maybe next year? Maybe the end of this year? Who knows? But I just want to say, you know, thank you, because it genuinely means so much to me. We're gonna come to each and every one of your houses. Look out your window. That's me. I'm coming at you lightning speed. I gotta give all of you a big hug for helping me get this far. But yeah, I decided to celebrate this milestone with a very special video. I let you guys vote on it, and you guys chose My Little Pony Next Gen. So it's a My Little Pony Next Gen. I might have some weird ships that I used. I'll go ahead and explain that, why not, to fill up some time in the video, because I also just want to talk about it, because I spent a lot of time thinking about this. So let's start off with Twilight, since she's like the whole thing. So Twilight isn't actually with anybody. She had a surrogate baby with Starburst. She's like, I don't have time for a relationship, but I need a child for political reasons, and I also just want a child in general. So, hey you, powerful unicorn, let's perform eugenics and make powerful unicorn baby. Like, my baby might not end up an alicorn, but it'll be a damn powerful unicorn. So yeah, Twilight and Starburst. Second kiddo, let's go to Rainbow Dash. Rainbow Dash, ex Zephyr Breeze. My original idea was that they were in a marriage and it was failing, so they're like, let's have a kid, and then that didn't work out, and then Rainbow left Zephyr. But Trot, one of my friends, longtime viewers will know who that is, Trot was like, oh, what if it was like a one-night stand and it was an accident? And I was like, that's the idea, champ, that's the fucking idea. So Zephyr and RD had a one-night stand, popped out a kid, and then RD went to go date Applejack so that the kid would have a strong male figure growing up, because yes, my Applejack is trans mask. No, I do not take criticism. Next up, we got Starlight Glimmer. Okay, I know she's not technically a part of the main six, but since I paired Rainbow Dash and Applejack together, and I didn't think Applejack would have any kids of her own besides Rainbow's like adoptive kid situation, I decided to use Starlight. Originally, I was gonna pair Starlight with Sunburst, but my friend Greg was like, hey, Starburst gay, and I was like, you know what, you're right, it makes sense with the whole Twilight thing with the artificial insemination, but like, not so much, you know, with Starlight Glimmer. So I was like, okay, Starlight Glimmer's obviously got a Twilight complex, like absolutely, definitely 100% has a crush on Princess Twilight Sparkle, but since she can't act on it, just be awkward, she ends up getting together with Moondancer, which is just Twilight, but with a different coat genuinely. Their relationship is dysfunctional at best and really unhealthy at worst. But I think they'd make a cute couple, and they would both try really hard to stay with each other. And, you know, their baby is so cute. Oh, I'm so proud of the work I did. Next, we have Rarity, who Rarity is kind of in a rare pair in this situation. I paired her up with Spitfire. Okay, I have an explanation for this. I promise. Just stick with me because you'll also think it's cute. Rarity attends all of Rainbow Dash's Wonderbolt shows. Okay, just to be supportive friend, you know, hanging out, whatever. And one day at one of the shows, on the Jumbotron, it zooms in on Spitfire's face, and Spitfire winks at the crowd, and Rarity's heart goes boom. Big, strong lady, pretty. And Rarity goes up to Rainbow Dash after the game and is like, hey, bestie, can you introduce me to Spitfire? Like, just get us a little closer, because sapphic crush go burr. And Rainbow Dash goes, hell yeah, bestie. And they get together, and it's super cute. And because Rarity needs to end up with, like, a celebrity, right? Spitfire is a celebrity. And a big, strong female, okay? And we all know that Rarity needed to be with someone who was big and strong, okay? So I do not take criticism. Spitfire x Rarity, good shit. Next, we'll go to the obvious one of the whole main six, Fluttershy x Discord. I don't have to explain this. Y'all already know what's up. I couldn't think of anyone else for Fluttershy to be with, so Discord it was. As I said, not gonna explain it. Y'all already know what the fuck is up. And last, but certainly not least, we have Pinkie Pie, who, let me explain, is paired with someone that you might not even know the name of. So Pinkie doesn't actually know who the father of her kid is. She accidentally got pregnant at a, like, rave party that she went to, and she was having relations with a lot of people, and one of those people happened to be a character by the name of Fresh Coat. Now, Fresh Coat is a background pony who is female that appeared in one episode once. Okay, but I love her design. I thought it was so good. And I was like, wouldn't it be funky if those two got together? So I said, Fresh Coat is under a gender change spell for the night, and then has relations with Pinkie, and then changes back the next day. So Pinkie has no idea, like, who the baby daddy is, and Fresh Coat has no idea that she has a kid out there. And I know that's kind of weird, but I am pushing a Fresh Coat agenda, okay? She, good shit. So yeah, that's my main six next gen. Any thoughts? Leave a comment down below and tell me what you would have done, or tell me what you liked about mine, and I'll definitely respond and we can have a conversation about it. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. Thank you so, so much for 2K. It means the world to me. And I hope to see you all again very, very soon. I have more content coming out, and hopefully it'll go fast. So hopefully I'll have some more stuff out for you as soon as possible. But yeah, mwah. I love you all so much. Bye.